Thank you. Without wasting our time, we are commencing this program. I want to invite God's own choir of St. George to come up to the stage to sing the national anthem. Please come over. Thank you. Please, can we appreciate them as they're coming up on the stage? CIBN anthem.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Let's be seated. I want to call on our second Vice President, Professor Pius Olariwaju, FCIB, to take the opening prayer.
I will respectively stand for prayers. Our Father and our God, we want to give you all thanks today. We are gathered here again among in the land of the living to exalt your name this year. What a great God you have. We thank you because your presence has been with us since the beginning of the year. Even up to this moment, may your name be praised. Individually, you have touched our life. Corporately, the CIBN has been, continue to rise from grace to grace. Father, it can only be you. And that is why we have gathered this evening, this evening of song, to sing songs of praises and adoration to your great name. Our Father and our God, even as we come together to worship you. We pray, Lord, that your presence will be felt in our midst in Jesus' name. As many that are here rejoicing, their joy will increase in Jesus' name. As many that are believing you for one thing or the other before the year runs to an end, we know you are a great God. Nothing is impossible with you. We pray, Lord, that you will meet them at the very point of their need. Our Father, even as we prepare for the new year, our expectations are great. But as much as our expectations are great, you are a greater God. We pray that you will meet us individually in our various needs in Jesus' name. Even as we commence this program, we commence in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Please, let's be seated. I want to welcome on behalf of the Governing Council, the office holders, management of staff of the Institute to the Evening of Songs 3.0. Now, before we go to the next agenda, we want to recognize some of our important guests that we have here in this program. Let's welcome our president, Dr. Bayo Olugbemi, FCIB. You're welcome to the program, sir. But the next is our first vice president, Dr. Ken Opara, FCIB. And the second vice president who just took the opening prayer is Professor Pius Olariwaju, FCIB. The National Treasurer, Mr. Dede Alabi, FCIB, you're welcome, sir. I also use this opportunity to welcome our World Registrar, Dr. Sheye Awojobi, FCIB. Now, I would like to also recognize our past presidents that are in this program. The first is Mr. Raf Osayeme, FCIB. Thank you for joining us, sir. Second is Mazi Osike Unnebo, FCIB. You're welcome, sir. Then, joining us online, with a round of applause, I would like us to welcome Mr. Laoye Jayola, FCIB. This is also to recognize other members of council here present and our guest ministers. The first up here is Reverend S.A. Fagbemi, the minister in charge, First Baptist Church, Lagos.
Recording you're welcome, in sir. Progress.
Now the second is Pastor J.U. Obaemi, National Overseer, the Redeemed Christian Church of God. You're welcome, sir. Now, okay, so without wasting much time, I also want to recognize the presence of Right Reverend Stephen Adebite, the Chairman, Christian Association of Nigeria, Lagos Chapter. Okay, I've been told him he's on his way. So let's welcome our president, Dr. Bayo Olubemi, FCIB, for his welcome address. Thank you.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. The first vice president of our great institute, Dr. Kenneth Okpara, PhD FCIB. The second vice president, Professor Pius Oladeji Olaniwaju, PhD FCIB. The national treasurer, Mr. Dele Alabi, FCIB. Past presidents here present, I can recognize the acting chairman of the body of past presidents and my father, Mr. Ralph Sayene, FCIB. Our past president, Mazi OCK Unegu, FCIB. Our lords here present, Sir Richard. My own father, the National Overseer of RCCG, Pastor J.O. Obaemi. Thank you, Danny, for coming. The Reverend Dr. Sunday Fagbemi, the Minister in charge of the Baptist Church, Lagos, Cross Street, Lagos. You're welcome, sir. In absentia, we're still expecting the Chairman of Lagos State Chapter of the Christian Association of Nigeria, Bishop Stephen Adegbite, in absentia. Other ministers of the Gospel here present. Fellows, associates, management staff, and other distinguished personalities here present. You are all welcome. Good evening. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, it's with great pleasure that I warmly welcome you all to the CIBN Evening of Songs 3.0. That is a third in a series. I acknowledge and appreciate all our esteemed stakeholders from across the globe who have made our time to join us at this program, both physically and on the virtual platform. I'm particularly thankful to God for sparing our lives to witness the end of another year. Indeed, the year 2021 is a very, very eventful year, which came with various challenges, trials, tribulations, and of course, success stories for individuals, corporates, and governments at all levels. It's not all bad news. During the year under review, we grapple with the emergence of two new variants of COVID-19 virus, the Delta variant and recently the Omicron variant, which has officially landed us in the fourth wave of the pandemic in Nigeria and across the world. The business environment was tough and challenging amidst rising spate of insecurity in the business environment and in the land. But in all this, we were more than conquerors through Christ who strengthened us, and we do have reasons to be thankful to our God. For instance, our economy bounced back from shocks occasioned by the pandemic in 2020, growing approximately 4% in 2021 compared to minus 3.62% in quarter three of the previous year. As an institute, we recorded unprecedented successes in all our programs in the outgoing year. We had a banking and finance conference that was reputed and adjudged to be the largest gathering of banking and finance stakeholders in Africa, with about 10,000 participants in attendance. We commence the execution of legacy projects in our institutions across the country. This has never been before. And what does that mean? We plan, or we are giving back to our communities, our stakeholders, by building state-of-the-art lecture centers in at least six of our institutions across the nation who are linked with us professionally. And we have to date laid the foundation of three of them: the Polytechnic Ibadan, the Abubakar Tabubakar University in Bauchi, and the Federal Polytechnic Makerere. In the next 1 month or so, we will name the foundation school of three other ones, one in the South Side, which is the River State University in Port Harcourt. We'll be doing that of Kano State Polytechnic in Kano and Nasarawa State Polytechnic in Nasarawa State, by the grace of God. And we hope that all these six projects will be concluded before our tenure elapses in May 2023, by the grace of God. We also hosted the 56th Annual Bankers Seminar that was well attended by stakeholders and the banking and finance ecosystem. Not forgetting that we launched the new syllabi for the banking professional examinations and certification programs, as well as we launched the CIBN mentoring scheme for young professionals in the banking industry, just to mention a few of what we've been able to achieve. It is in view of this that we feel obliged to host this program as a platform for members of the institute and the banking community to come together under a relaxed atmosphere, engulfed with soul-lifting music, to express our gratitude to God Almighty for bringing us this far. It could have been worse. I welcome very specially our River past president here present. I am sure you are delighted to see that we are building on the solid foundation that you lay. I must convey my unreserved appreciation to the Board of Bank CEOs, who have been a great pillar of support in the year under review. I thank you all immensely and look forward to more support in the years ahead. I thought I heard the name of Mr. Is he here? Oh, he's online. Okay. That I won't breach protocol.
I am online, sir.
My past president, you are welcome, sir. My past president,
yes, sir.
My mentor, the one that drafted me into the politics of CIBN. Thank you very much, sir. Anywhere you are, God bless you.
Welcome. Thank you, sir.
He also taught me Pastor Banking too, so he's my teacher for life. I'm my ego. Permit me at this juncture to welcome our distinguished guests to Bankers House and to the Gathering of Bankers, my Lord Spiritual Bishop Stephen Adegbite, Chairman, Christian Association of Nigeria, Lagos Chapter, Daddy Pastor Joe Obayemi, National Overseer of the Redeemed Christian Church of God, representing the GO, Daddy Pastor Yi Adeboye, and Reverend Dr. Sunday A. Fagbemi, the Minister in Charge of First Baptist Church, Lagos. We thank you all for your esteemed presence. Let me close my remarks by encouraging us all to reflect on the significance of this season. Christmas is the celebration of the birth of our Lord Jesus Christ, who exemplifies compassion, peace, love, and good tidings. As we celebrate this evening, let us embody his character and spread goodwill, not just during the festive season, but all through our lifetime. I pray that the peace, with the Prince of Peace brought to the world, will reign in our households, in our villages, in our towns, in our cities, and as well as our nation as a whole. Once again, I thank you all for your presence, and I wish you a Merry Christmas and a prosperous New Year. Thank you, and God bless you all.
We can do better for the president. Thank you. As the God's Own Choir comes up for the praise medley, I want to recognize the very Reverend Oye Awojobi from the Methodist Church of Nigeria. Thank you for coming, sir. So I don't know if you are ready. Are we ready? So Are we ready? If we are ready, please, let's stand to our feet. We are going to the first praise medley for the program. So the God's Own Choir is going to take us through. Most of us are wearing suits today, so I don't know if you'll be able to dance, but I know that should not debar us from dancing. God has been faithful this year.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Can we just wave our hands to honor this God? Can we appreciate him for life? From January, February, March, April,
December. Amen.
The Lord has been faithful, and we have a cause to glorify him. So can we just worship him this evening? Hallelujah. appreciate God with the passing offering. If you should count the goodness of God over your life on January and December, it's not enough standing before His presence. Hallelujah.
Oh,
blessing, I would like to recognize the presence of one of our past presidents, Mr. Femi Epudayo, FCIB. You're welcome, sir. And also our past president, Dr. Uche Olowu, MNI, FCIB, and his wife. Welcome, sir. Welcome, ma'am. All right. So, okay. God has not joined you together. My apologies, sir. You're welcome, sir. You're welcome, ma'am. And that is Mrs. B, a council member of CIBM. I think the face mask is trying to deceive me. I want to call on, I want God's own choir band to get ready. In fact, I want you to come to the stage so that we don't take much time. I want to also recognize the wife of our president, Mrs. Olupemi, here in our midst. You're welcome. To take our first lesson, I want to call on Reverend Sunday Fagbemi, Minister in Charge, First Baptist Church, Lagos. You're welcome, sir.
Our first lesson is taken from Genesis chapter 3. And we start to read from verse number 8 unto verse 15. The fall of man. I read in Jesus' name. Then the man and his wife had a son of the Lord God as he was walking in the garden in the cool of the day. And they hid from the Lord God among the trees of the garden. But the Lord God called to the man, "Where are you?" He answered, "I heard you in the garden, and I was afraid because I was naked, so I hid." And he said, "Who told you that you were naked? Have you eaten from the tree that I commanded you not to eat from?" The man said, "The woman you put here with me, she gave me some fruit from the tree, and I ate it." Then the Lord God said to the woman, "What is this you have done?" The woman said, "The serpent deceived me, and I ate." So the Lord God said to the serpent, "Because you have done this, cause that you above all livestock and all the wild animals, you will crawl on your belly and you will eat dust all the days of your life." The last verse. "And I will put enmity between you and the woman and between your offspring and hers, and it shall crush your head and you will strike is here." We are victorious in Christ Jesus and will forever be victorious in Jesus' name.
Please tell your neighbor soon it will be Christmas Day. Please tell your neighbor soon to be Christmas Day. Yes, Christmas is the best season in the world. No doubt, if you go everywhere, every street, you know that something is about to happen. I will know for sure that as you celebrate today, God will give you grace to celebrate many more years to come in Jesus' name. Enjoy as the choir presents to you. Soon it will be Christmas Day. Ding dong, merry and high, and sweet charming Christmas Day.
Christmas, to the God who lives inside.
deserve a better round of applause. Before I call on our past president, Mr. Lawoye Jayola, FCIB, to give the second lesson, to read the second lesson, I want to recognize the presence of one of our past presidents, Dr. Segun Aina, FCIB. You're welcome, sir. So we call on our past president, Mr. Lawoye Jayola, FCIB, to take the second lesson.
The second lesson for this year's Festival of Nine Lessons and Carols is taken from the book of Genesis, chapter 22, from verses 15 to 18. And the angel of the Lord called upon Abraham out of...
President, please, we can't hear you.
I'm loud, I'm hearing myself. That should be you. Hello.
You're live, sir.
Good. So, the second lesson for this... The second lesson for this year's annual Festival of Nine Lessons and Carols is taken from the book of Genesis, chapter 22, verses 12 to 18. And the angel of the Lord called upon Abraham out of heaven the second time and said, "By myself have I sworn, said the Lord, for because thou hast done this thing and hast not withheld thy son, thine only son, that in blessing I will bless thee, and in multiplying I will multiply thy seeds as the stars of the heaven and as the sand which is upon the seashore. And thy seed shall possess the gate of his enemy. And in thy seed shall all the nations of the earth be blessed, because thou hast obeyed my voice." This is the word of the Lord.
Thank you, our past president, Mr. Lawoye Jayola. I want us to rise as we take the hymn, the congregational hymn, "While Shepherds Watch." Congregational hymn, let's rise to take it.
Thank you.
Amen. To take the top lesson, I want to invite Mrs. Fumi Balogun, FCIB, our council member. Please come take.
Praise the Lord. The third lesson for this evening of song is taken from the book of Isaiah, chapter 9, verses 2 to 7. And I read in Jesus' name. The people that walk in darkness have seen a great light. They that dwell in the land of the shadow of the dead, upon them has the light shine. That has multiplied the nation and not increased the joy. They joy before thee, according to the joy in harvest, and as men rejoice when they divide the spoil. For thou hast broken the yoke of his body and the staff of his shoulder, the rod of his oppressors, as in the day of Midian. For every battle of the warrior is with confused noise, and the garments roll in blood, but this shall be with burning and fuel of fire. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and the peace, there shall be no end, upon the throne of David and upon his kingdom, to order it and to establish it with judgment and with justice, from henceforth, even forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will perform this. This is the word of the Lord.
God bless you, man. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
The next carol, we are taking two songs. The first one is titled Calypso, while the second one is titled Nothing is Impossible with God. Can you tell me about that? Nothing is impossible with God. I know your dreams are very, very big as a company. It's a prayer that nothing is impossible for you to achieve that dream. Come 2022 in Jesus' name. Thank you.
you. To read the fourth lesson of tonight, I want to call on our past president, Mr. Ralph Osayeme, FCIB.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. The fourth lesson for this special night of songs is taken from Isaiah chapter 11, verses 1 to 9. Isaiah 11, verses 1 to 9. And there shall come forth a rod out of the stem of Jesse, and a branch shall grow out of his roots, and the Spirit of the Lord shall rest upon him, the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of counsel and might, the spirit of knowledge and of the fear of the Lord. And shall make him of quick understanding in the fear of the Lord, and he shall not judge after the sight of his eyes, neither reprove after the hearing of his ears. But with righteousness shall he judge the poor, and reprove with equity for the meek of the earth. And he shall smite the earth with the rod of his mouth, and with the breath of his lips shall he slay the wicked. And righteousness shall be the girdle of his loins, and faithfulness the girdle of his reins. The wolf also shall dwell with the lamb, and the leopard shall lie down with the kid, and the calf and the young lion and the fatling together, and a little child shall lead them. And the cow and the bear shall feed, their young ones shall lie down together, and the lion shall eat straw like the ox. And the sucking child shall play on the hole of the sasp, and the wind child shall put his hand on the cockerel's den. They shall not hurt nor destroy in any my holy mountain, for the earth shall be full of the knowledge of the Lord, as the waters cover the sea. This is the word of the Lord.
Thank you. We'd like the congregation to rise as we take the hymn, O Come All Ye Faithful. be seated. Praise the Lord. I want to call on Sir Bola Ofolayan, FCIB, former MD Equatorial Trust Bank Limited, to take the fifth lesson. Please let's clap our hands for Sir Bola Ofolayan.
Lesson for this special service of Evening of Songs is found in the book of Luke, chapter 1, begin from the 26th verse. St. Luke 1, begin from the 26th verse. And in the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God unto a city of Galilee named Nazareth, to a virgin espoused to a man whose name was Joseph, of the house of David, and the virgin's name was Mary. And the angel came in unto her and said, "Hail, thou that art favored, the Lord is with thee, blessed art thou among women." And when she saw him, she was troubled at his saying, and cast in her mind what manner of salutation this should be. And the angel said unto her, "Fear not, Mary, for thou hast found favor with God. And behold, thou shalt conceive in thy womb and bring forth a son, and shall call his name Jesus. He shall be great, and shall he call the Son of the Highest, and the Lord God shall give unto him the throne of his father David. And he shall reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there shall be no end." Then said Mary unto the angel, "How shall this be, seeing I know not a man?" And the angel answered and said unto her, "The Holy Ghost shall come upon thee, and the power of the Highest shall overshadow thee. Therefore also that holy thing which shall be born of thee shall be called the Son of God. And behold, thy cousin Elizabeth, she hath also conceived a son in her old age, and this is the sixth month with her who was called barren. For with God, nothing is impossible." And Mary said, "Behold, the handmaid of the Lord, be it unto me according to thy word." And the angel departed from her. This is the word of God.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. So we'll continue by taking another congregational hymn. I want us to be all standing as we take the hymn, "Once in Royal David City." Once in Royal David City. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. You know, we have a future in banking, and we have future bankers in the house. Millennials in the house, shout hallelujah. I'm disappointed. You see, we have past presidents that are shouting hallelujah more than you guys. Okay, millennials in the house, make some noise. You know, I'm just trying to warm you guys up. I want you to shout a better hallelujah. Millennials in the house, shout a better hallelujah. Thank you, that's more like it. I want to welcome my colleague, Miss Gladys Dan Fulani, representing the millennial, to take the sixth lesson. Thank you. Please, let's clap for her.
Everyone. The sixth lesson of the evening of songs is taken from the first gospel book of Matthew, chapter 1, beginning from the 18th verse until the 25th verse. And I'll start with the 18th verse. Now, the birth of Jesus Christ was on this wise: when as his mother Mary was espoused to Joseph, before they came together, she was found with child of the Holy Ghost. Then Joseph, her husband, being a just man and not willing to make her a public example, was minded to put her away privily. But while he thought on these things, behold, the angel of the Lord appeared unto him in a dream, saying, Joseph, thou son of David, fear not to take unto thee Mary thy wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Ghost. And she shall bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sins. And now all this was done, that it might be fulfilled which was spoken of the Lord by the prophet, saying, behold, the virgin shall be with a child, and shall bring forth a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, which being interpreted is God with us. Then Joseph, being raised from the sleep, did as the angel of the Lord had bidden him, and took unto him his wife. The last verse, 25th verse. And knew her not until she had brought forth his firstborn son, and he called his name Jesus. Thank you.
Thank you, my colleague Gladys, please. Let's appreciate her. Earlier, we introduced in our midst the national overseer of the Redeemed Christian Church of God. I'm very happy that he's here with us. This is not a story, this is for real, to have you, sir, in our presence. So I want to welcome you to this podium, sir, to come and take the short exhortation for this program. Please, can we appreciate Pastor Obayemi, National Overseer, RCCG.
That clapping is for me, it's from God. But to the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the Lord of Hosts, the I am that is I am, the everlasting Father, the one who kept you alive, that you can stand on your feet, that your hands are still functioning, your leg can still carry you. Shout a victorious hallelujah! We give glory to Almighty God that made us to see this day. I bring greeting to you from my daddy, my father in the Lord, the General Overseer of the Redeemed Christian Church of God, Pastor E. Adeboye, praying for all of us that the siege is over in Jesus' name. Amen. And we shall be moving in the way of glory in Jesus' name. Can they let us pray? Heavenly Father, we say thank you. The giver of life, we appreciate you. The Alpha and Omega, we exalt your name. If we look back, what has been happening around us
within our vicinity in the nations of the world that we are here today, it can only be you. Thank you for your mercy that have kept us, that has sustained us, that has sustained this institute. May your name be praised in Jesus' name. The brief moment we are to spend here, Holy Spirit, take over in the name of Jesus. As this year is rolling away, it will not roll any of you away in Jesus' name. It will roll in greater joy and achievement to you all in Jesus' name. And together we shall make heaven in Jesus' name. In Jesus' mighty name we are praying. Praise ye the Lord. Can they be seated, sir and ma? I humbly, by permission, stand on the existing protocol due to my time. I'm given a topic to speak on that is transcending the horizon. Transcending the horizon. Let me read quickly Daniel chapter 5, and I will rush through from verse 7 to 12. Daniel 5, 7 to 12. The king cried aloud to bring the astrologers, the Chaldeans, and the soothsayers. The king spoke, saying to the wise men of Babylon, whoever read this writing and tell me its interpretation shall be clothed with purple and have a chain of gold around his neck, and I shall be the third ruler in the kingdom. Now, all the king wise men came, but they could not read the writing or make known to the king his interpretation. The king Belshazzar was greatly troubled. His countenance was changed, and his lord were astonished. The queen, because of the words of the king and his lord, came to the banquet hall. The king spoke, saying, O king, live forever. Do not let your thoughts trouble you, nor let your countenance change. There is a man in your kingdom in whom is the spirit of the Holy God. In the days of your father, light and understanding and wisdom, like the wisdom of the gods, were found in him. And King Nebuchadnezzar, your father, the king, made him chief of the magicians, astrologers, Chaldeans, and soothsayers. Inasmuch as an excellent spirit, knowledge, understanding, interpreting dreams, solving riddles, and explaining enigma were found in this Daniel, whom the king named Belshazzar. Now, let Daniel be called, and he will give the interpretation. I want to believe there is a man among us who will provide solution to the economy situation of Nigeria in Jesus' name. Transcending the horizon. It looked like a big world, but saying a way that you can go beyond an ordinary. You can break records and set other records. You can perform beyond expectation. That's all about. And as God liveth, the level I find you today will ever be the least experience in your life in Jesus' name. When God made man, he gave him authority to have dominion, to live beyond the ordinary. And every human being aspire to reach the senate either of his profession, of his career, or business. But after getting to that apex, the question you just find yourself asking, of all that I've known, there are still more to know. Of all that I've done, we still have more to do. And of all that I've achieved, there are still some things yet to be achieved. As long as man is alive, he's not permitted to be statistics. If there's anyone who has been stagnated one way or the other, by the name that is above every other name,
Stagnation is terminated in Jesus' name. Because when we talk to transcend, we are saying to break a record and set another record. We are saying to exceed expectation. And we are saying that you are able to go above limits. That's what transcending means, beyond the ordinary, transcending beyond the horizon. I discovered that one could be highly successful, but not transcending. Highly successful still remain ordinary. If you don't believe me, let's go through, because I have a few minutes. I won't be able to read as I ought to, because by the time they sent me this letter yesterday evening and I will see the time, I say, maybe I just come and pray for you and then go. Let somebody shout hallelujah. In Luke chapter 5, when you begin to read from verse 1, you have a story of a good businessman there. He was born into the business, and when he grew up, he wanted to enlarge the business, and he went to partnership. His name is called Peter. He was a fisherman. He was in fishing business. A day came like this. He gave his boat to Jesus to use. And why was he doing that? He toiled all night and failed. He could not achieve his aim. But because he gave his boat for Jesus to use, when Jesus finished, he said, cast the boat onto the deep. You know the story. He said, there is nothing here, but because of thy word, I will do what you wanted me to do. He casted it, and that was the greatest success of his business. Because he caught net breaking fishes, and he has to ask all the partners to join to the bumper office. But do you know that supernatural breakthrough of his business happened to be the beginning of his transcending? Why? When you get to verse 10, Jesus said, from now onward, you will no longer fish for fishes, but you'll be fishing for men. One can be successful, highly successful, but not fulfilling purpose. It was that day that he made a U-turn, transcending from business tycoon to a fishers of men. And not only that, he was the first apostle to preach, and 3,000 people gave their lives. And he went further to such an extent that what was not recorded in the ministry of Jesus Christ was recorded in his favor. That when he is passing, his shadow alone began to heal the sick. So he transcended from ordinary ignorant man and a fisherman to somebody whose shadow now healing the sick. You will go beyond your dream after now in Jesus' name. I will give you another example before I go to how we transcend. There was a brilliant man, a successful lawyer. His name is called Saul. He learned under the best professor, and he became one as such. And he was connected to the power that be. Succeeded professionally, and having succeeded professionally, he wanted more for life. He wanted power, and he went to the government, collected authority and permission to do what he knows how to do best. But when he got to Acts of Apostles chapter 26, he was recounting the history of his life. He said, on his way as he was going, a light shined, and all the light covered him and those that were to him. I pray that the light will shine unto you today in Jesus' name. And he had an envelope vision. So when the light shined, Jesus asked him, why are you kicking against me? He said, who art thou? To cut the story short, he surrendered to Jesus totally. Whatever you want me to do, I will do. when he was recounting this story to King Agrippa in Acts of Apostles chapter 26, I think verse 19 of it, he said, I was not disobedient to this heavenly vision. What is that telling you and I? For you to transcend, you need to have an encounter with Jesus Christ. Some people are in the wrong part of their destiny, and yet they are using all their energy to pursue that wrong course. Such was Peter until he had an encounter. An unlearned person became what we are talking about in the Institute of Bankers after 2,000 years. Number two, the Paul that we are talking about had the heavenly vision, a divine vision. That turned his vision around from what he thought it would be to what God wanted him to become. And he was highly used so much that his handkerchief alone began to heal the sick. If he had died as a lawyer, nobody would have remembered him again today. That reminded me of somebody still living in this country. He was a successful lawyer, was signed by title or whatever they call it, and later decided to retire and go into education. Do you know today, many people did not even know him by or identify him with law. They only know him by the institute they established. And his name is not only in Nigeria, all over the world, just by another vision. So by the time he was being a successful lawyer, he thought he had have it all. So I'm telling you, brethren, no matter the level you are, you can go beyond the ordinary. And I will not never be an ordinary one in Jesus' name. I don't know about you. Now, how do you transcend beyond the ordinary? Number one, when we look at the scripture, you must charge yourself for excellence and for fulfillment. The best you have today, if not improved upon, will become not too good tomorrow. What everybody is embracing today, I don't have time to tell you story, I could have said so many things, will become an old school tomorrow. And when your successor continues to say, we are improving on what you have done, that means another phase has set in entirely. For you not to be outdated in life and to transcend beyond the ordinary, you must charge yourself to be an excellent one in your career, excellent in your pursuit, so that you will not become outdated. This is what Paul realized in Philippians chapter 4, 13 and 14. Philippians 4, 13. I'm sorry, I can't follow my note anymore because of shortage of time. So kindly forgive me. He said, one thing I do, forgetting those things that were behind and pressing forward to those things that were before. He said, I stretch towards the mark of high calling. Every one of us have ability to do more than what we are doing and achieve more than whatsoever we have achieved. Because when we are created, we are given dominion. In those days, we used to say, sky is the limit. And that was when ego was the lord of the sky. But when technology set in and people begin to go to the space now, the sky began to be the beginning. So where you are now can get better. Tell your neighbor you can get better. Tell another person you can grow higher. And tell somebody I'm going to achieve more than I ever achieved. Let somebody shout hallelujah.
Number two that comes to my mind is that you must set your vision before yourself. No matter how big the vision is, of course, if your vision is not bigger than you, it's not a good vision that can transcend you beyond the horizon. In Genesis chapter 15, maybe from verse 1, Genesis 15, God himself had to call Abraham out. Abraham was given a promise that his children will be like the sand and like the stars. Abraham continued to say, Lord, let this my day. After 20 years, nothing to show for it. But when you get to Genesis 15, God has to do what we call demonstration. He has to call him out. He said, he should begin to count the stars. After counting and counting and counting, he said, that is how your children are going to be. How many children of Abraham are here? Shout hallelujah. At that time, it was practically impossible, but he opened his spiritual eyes. Until your spiritual eyes are open, you cannot transcend beyond the ordinary. Until you receive an heavenly vision like Paul did, you cannot transcend. Oh, thank you, Father. I just want to say something I was running away from. As I sat down there, God was ministering to me that someone here among us, he gave you an idea and you discounted it. He said you should go and revisit it because it's going to be springboard for your breakthrough. Yeah. I don't know who you are. You know, he had to call Abraham out. You must set your vision before you if you must transcend beyond the ordinary. I want to cite my beloved daddy, our General Vasia, for example. When we have the second auditorium and we were rejoicing, and he told us that, do you see this auditorium? It become children auditorium. We believed him before in many things, but when he was saying this, we said, this cannot be. And one of those who say it cannot be. But he set his vision before himself. Whether we believe it or not, eventually it comes to pass. Why am I saying this to you? I don't know where you asked me to speak about transcending the horizon in Christmas celebration. But I must see that someone here who may be thinking he have achieved a lot and he will leave his rest for the children. You are not starting yet because God is going to give you a new beginning in the mighty name of Jesus. So when we are transcending, we need a vision and not just ordinary vision from whom, a vision that is divinely. Number three, we must not forget whatever we can say we do without Christ in our life, we are nothing. In John chapter 15, when you begin to read from verse 5 and 6, he said, I am the vine. You are just the branches. Any branch in me that connected with me are the one that will bear fruit. He said, without me, you can do nothing. It does not say you cannot try. It does not say you cannot use your connection. It does not say you cannot use your expertise, but you won't get the expected result. Many of us who are older, we know of a great politician in this nation, Nigeria, whose book has been read by the politician till today, of whom British government have to say, if this man can reign or rule Nigeria for 3 to 6 months, the British government or nation will be running after Nigeria. He got all he could, all it takes to become a prime minister, but it doesn't work out.
And when you now look at the Genesis, they saw a vision right from time that it will be a priest unto the Lord, but he chose to be a politician. With all the wisdom and all the technical know-how, he did not get there. You will not be a failure in Jesus' name. You will reach your purpose and destiny in Jesus' name. So, Lord Jesus Christ is the foundation of everything that we can become. According to the word of God in Philippians chapter 4, verse 13, he said, 4:13, he said, I can do all things through Christ that do all that strengthen me. The arm of flesh will fail us. Technology may fail us. Science or scientists, they may fail us. If you don't believe me, Prophet Nye has already made it possible. They are still trying. God bless the scientists. God bless the work of their hands. They are still trying, but they didn't have solution. They didn't have predomination that this was coming, but it came. When technology fails, where do you run to? When you meet yourself at crossroads, who do you run to? When situation becomes an impossibility, who do you ask for help? You must have a foundation in the Lord Jesus Christ. It's Matthew 6:33. He says, seek ye first the kingdom of God and all his righteousness, and all other things shall be added unto it. Where you are today can never define you. God knows what he wants you to become. And until you fulfill that purpose, you are not yet transcending. Shall we pray? As we bow our head down, maybe you want to make Jesus your Lord. You want to hand over the totality of your life to him. You want to pursue his kingdom so that other things could be pursuing you. That is, whatever you want in life will also be pursuing you. Can you kindly raise up your hand where you are so that I will pray with you? Say, Lord, I want to surrender totally to your kingdom. I want to pursue your kingdom from today so that I can transcend beyond ordinary. Just keep the hands up there. I will pray with you. Let me just see the hands. You are not coming forward. Lord, just let me see the hands. I'm going to pray with you. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you, man. God bless you. God bless you, sir. God bless. Keep the hand there. I'm just going to pray with you now. Father, I thank you for your word. I thank you for all these your children that raising their hand towards you, knowing fully that you are the controller of their life. They are submitting their life to you. Please receive them in Jesus' name. Save their soul in Jesus' name. Wash away their sins in Jesus' name. And the height they never dreamt of, by your power, you will leave them there in Jesus' name. And together we shall make heaven in Jesus' name. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Amen. God bless those hands. In case you want to more counseling or you want me to give your name to Daddy, the general overseer, to be praying with you, get my number and send me text of your details. Daddy will get in touch with you. To the many of us, today can be a different day because every day look like ordinary, but God can bring extraordinary things out. What do you want God to do for you before the end of this year? Can you ask him as you bow down our heads, what do you want God to do for you between now and end of this year, that you will stand and testify? Thank you, Father. Let me bring in our prayer to a close. Almighty and everlasting Father, and spoken your word in a brief moment that I was allotted to us. I've made them to know whom you are, that you are unlimited God. And because you are unlimited, they cannot be limited. Everything limiting their success, their joy, their glory, their promotion, remove now in Jesus' name. Almighty and everlasting Father, whatever thing they have asked from you, you are God of all flesh. Nothing is too difficult for you. Answer them by fire in the name of Jesus. Turn salt to testimony in the name of Jesus. Between now and end of this year, that kind of miracle no man can perform in their life. Do it in the name of Jesus. And as we have heard about you, transcending all beyond the horizon, none of your children here will be ordinary in Jesus' name. You will leave them higher spiritually in Jesus' name, physically in Jesus' name, career-wise in Jesus' name. And the institute will be lifted higher and higher and higher in the name of Jesus. And together, we shall make heaven in Jesus' name. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying.
Yes, you can do better. A standing ovation for the national overseer Redeemed Christian Church of God. Thank you for the blessing, sir. We appreciate you. Praise the Lord. I hope you've been blessed by that word. Yes, I believe. If you know, you are going to be 100 times better than this year. Next year, year 2022. Shout a bigger hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Are we tired? Please, can we just stand on our feet as we still praise God in you? Hallelujah. What a marvelous God. What a marvelous God. You have done marvelous things for me. What a powerful God. What a marvelous. He's here to do marvelous things for me. Hallelujah.
What a marvelous God. What a marvelous God. He has done marvelous things for me. What a powerful God. What a marvelous. He's here to do marvelous things for me.
Hallelujah.
What a marvelous God. What a marvelous God. Yes, a marvelous thing for me. What a powerful God. What a marvelous. He said to do marvelous things for me.
Things are impossible. Things are not uncannon. There are the things the Lord has done for me. What my father cannot do. What my mother cannot do. You have done it again and again. Hallelujah.
What a marvelous God. He has done marvelous things for me. What a powerful God. What a marvelous. He said to do marvelous things for me.
What a marvelous God. What a marvelous God. You have done marvelous things for me. Oh, what a powerful God. What a marvelous. He said to do marvelous things for me. Hallelujah.
What a marvelous God. What a marvelous. What a powerful God, what a marvelous. He said to do marvelous things for me.
Father, to you, Lord,
we are the glory.
To you, Jesus,
we are the honor.
To you, Eshadai,
we are the power and adoration forever.
Almighty Father, to you, Daddy,
we are the glory.
To you, Jesus,
we are.
glory. King of glory, receive all the honor. El Shaddai, I give you all the praise. Now forever and evermore. Father, to you, Lord.
We are the glory.
For you, to you, to you.
We are the honor.
To you, El Shaddai.
We are the power.
Permit me to recognize one of our special guests, the person of Right Reverend Dr. STV Ade Peter. Yes, he is the Methodist Bishop, Metropolitan Diocese of Ikeja, and also doubles as the chairman, Lagos State Christian Association of Nigeria chairman. Can we just clap our hands for him? We're glad to have you in our midst. You're welcome. I also want to recognize those people joining us online. If you can just enable your video, we want to say hi to all of you. Hi. Please, you can unmute. You can unmute and say hi to us. We wish you a Merry Christmas and Happy New Year. Now to take the seventh lesson of this program, I would like to call on Professor Mrs. Olayinka David West. She is the Associate Dean, Lagos Business School, and a Professor of Information System. She's joining us online. Prof, you can unmute your mic. And read the lesson, the seventh lesson. Thank you.
Thank you. Good evening. The seventh lesson is taken from the book of Matthew, chapter 2, reading from the first verse up to the 12th verse. Now, when Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, in the days of Herod the king, behold, there came wise men from the east to Jerusalem, saying, "Where is he that is born King of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east, and are come to worship him." When Herod the king had heard these things, he was troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. And when they had gathered all the chief priests and scribes of the people together, he demanded of them where Christ should be born. And they said unto him, "In the Bethlehem of Judea, for thus it is written by the prophet, and thou Bethlehem in the land of Judah, art not the least among the princes of Judah, for out of thee shall come a governor that shall rule my people Israel. Then Herod, when he had privily called the wise men, inquired of them diligently what time the star appeared. And he sent them to Bethlehem and said, go and search diligently for the young child. And when ye have found him, bring me word again, that I may come and worship him also. When they had heard the king, they departed. And lo, the star, which they saw in the east, went before them, till it came and stood over where the young child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceeding great joy. And when they were come into the house, they saw the young child with Mary his mother, and fell down and worshipped him. And when they had opened their treasures, they presented unto him gifts, gold, frankincense, myrrh. And being warned of God in a dream that they should not return to Herod, they departed into their own country another way. This is the word of the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Are we getting tired? We are getting to the sweetest part now. I want us to rise as we take the hymn, Hark the Herald Angels Sing. Thank to take the eighth lesson of this program, I want to call on Mrs. Yvonne Esiche, FCIB, the Member Governing Council.
The eighth lesson of the Festival of Nine Lessons and Carols is taken from Luke chapter 2, verses 1 to 20. Luke 2, 1 to 20. And it came to pass in those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And this taxing was the first made when Cyrenius was governor of Syria. And all went to be taxed, everyone in his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, unto the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, being great with child. And so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn. And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone around about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. You shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men. And it came to pass, as the angels were gone away from them into the heaven, the shepherds said one to another, let us now go unto Bethlehem and see this thing which is come to pass, which the Lord had made known to us. And they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in a manger. And when they had seen it, they made known abroad the saying which was told them concerning this child. And all they that had heard it wondered at those things which were told them by the shepherds. But Mary kept all these things and pondered them in her heart. And the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things that they had heard and seen, as it was told unto them, the word of the Lord.
Yes, this is the end part of the choir special ministration that is not on the program, starting with the one that says glory to God from the lesson, right? The second one is titled God of Israel, but we don't use God of Israel, we use God of Nigeria. And the last one on that segment is God bless us, everyone. Tell your neighbor, God bless you. Say your neighbor, God bless you. It shall be so for us and our family members in Jesus' name.
Thank you.
take the ninth lesson, I want to invite to the podium Right Reverend Dr. STB Adegbite, the Chairman, Lagos State Christian Association of Nigeria. You're welcome, sir.
Please shall we all rise for the ninth lesson. It's written in the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ that is all recorded by St. John chapter 1, beginning to read from the first verse. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by him, and without him was nothing made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. And the light shineth in darkness, and darkness comprehended not. There was a man sent from God, whose name was John. The same came for a witness, to bear witness of the light, that all men through him might believe. He was not that light, but was sent to bear witness to that light. And that was the true light, which lighteth every man that cometh into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made by him, and the world knew him not. He came unto his own, and his own received him not. But as many as received him, to them gave he power to become sons of God, even to them that believe on his name, which were born not of blood, nor of the will of man, or the will of flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. And the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us. And we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten Son of the Father, full of grace and truth. This is the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated. At this time, I'm asked to pray for our country, Nigeria, and also the Institute. But before I do that, let me say Merry Christmas and a prosperous New Year in advance to you all. I'm from the body of Christ in Lagos, and also in Nigeria, because I double as the director for national issues and social welfare at the national level for CAN. So on behalf of the president of CAN and Lagos State, we wish the Institute many more celebrations in the land of the living, and the good Lord will continue to uphold you, and it shall be well with you all, in Jesus' mighty name. Let us all pray. Our God and our Father, we thank you for this day. We thank you for the grace upon our life. We thank you for the year 2021. Father, we thank you despite all odds, despite all circumstances, negating the success of this year, but you've been able to prove to us in our country that you are our God. You have never changed and you will never change. And because your words are here and amen, we look back today confidently and conveniently. We say, Ebenezer, hitherto you've been able to help us, not by power, not by mind, but by your own grace. Be thou glorified forever in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you for the Institute, the Chartered Institute of Bankers in Nigeria, for 30 years of glorious existence, and for many more years that you will still give unto them. All the leaders that have served in the past, the present leadership, and people that will come in the future, Father, we are grateful unto you. In the name of Jesus Christ. Heavenly Father, we pray for our country as we grow into another year. Father, we pray 2022 will be the year we have been waiting for. Let there be good tidings on our journey. Father, protect us in 2022. May no evil befall any of us. We declare total peace in Nigeria because you came into the world and you brought peace. You are the Prince of Peace. Father, we are united in our request. we declare peace in the name of Jesus Christ. Peace in the northwest. Peace in the northeast. Peace in the north central. Peace in the south south. Peace in the southeast. Peace in the southwest. In the mighty name of Jesus. Heavenly Father, we pray. This is our home, Jerusalem. And we'll continue to pray for the goodness of this land. Father, we cover Nigeria with the blood of Jesus Christ. Any weapon formed against Nigeria will never prosper. Lord, King of glory, let there be confusion in the camps of the enemies. And let Nigeria move forward in the mighty name of Jesus. From January to December 2022, we decree and we declare, it shall be well with Nigeria. It shall be well with Nigerians in the mighty name of Jesus. For the Institute of Chartered Bankers, O Lord, in Nigeria, Father, we decree and we declare that goodness and mercy will follow all of you all the days of your life. Perpetually, you dwell in the presence of God in the mighty name of Jesus. For all the officers, O Lord, Lord, it shall be well with you. The grace of God will be sufficient for you. When you call on 1,000, we answer you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Heavenly Father, individually, I prophesy to your life that your heart desire for good. The Lord will grant sin before the end of the year in the name of Jesus. Heavenly King of glory, concerning your children, you will not mourn. You will not cry. Your heads will never be buried in shame. You will not crumble. You will not stumble. Rather, you continue to grow in the strength of God. My God will renew your strength more than the eagles. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, you will get to the crescendo of your glory. In the mighty name of Jesus, you will get to the zenith of your achievements. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, intercontinentally connection, you will be connected. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Father, I pray your glory will transcend the shores of Nigeria. In the name of Jesus, after all said and done, eternity will not elude any of us. If the Lord will take everything given to us, his anointing will never depart from our life. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Blessed be your name, O Lord. In Jesus' most wonderful name, we have prayed. And the people of the Lord will say, people of God will say, people of the Most High God are saying, can you do something for the Lord Jesus? Shalom.
Heaven deserves more round of applause, please. Program, I would like to call on our world registrar, Dr. Sheye Awojobi FCID.
Praise the Lord. I'm sure you agree with me that truly is an evening of songs. And the Lord will restore my voice. To God be the glory for all good things He has done in our life. I am taking solace in Psalm 101-2. And it says, shout for joy to the Lord, all the earth. Worship the Lord with gladness. Come before Him with joyful songs. Sing unto the Lord a joyful song. Hallelujah. Oh, my joy. On behalf of the President and Chairman of Council, a man of God who keeps on evangelizing on me every day for reasons best known, I want to say thank you to you, sirs. Thanks to God Almighty, and thanks to all our fathers, our mothers, the entire banking industry for seeing today, and we are gloriously entering 2022. I'd like to honorably express appreciation to the chairman of CAN Lagos State and the bishop of the Metropolitan See of the Methodist Church Nigeria in Lagos, Right Reverend STP Adebite. Thank you so much, sir. Your promise that you'll be here, even though today is also Lagos State. The Lagos State is, had its own Karo today along Marin at the State House. Thank you, sir. We also want to bless the name of God for us to move the entire redeem down to CIDA. It's not an easy thing. Praise the Lord. I see that the here ably represented when you say that the GO and you have that the JO, I'm sure both of them are here. The National Overseer RCCG Nigeria, Pastor Joe Bayani. Thank you so much. We also would like to thank the entire Baptist family for allowing Reverend Dr. S. F. Agbemi, the minister in charge of First Baptist, Lagos. Thank you so much. Our past president, they did wonderfully well. I know one of them who has been with us since 1 p.m. today. He came in at exactly 1 p.m. and he sat quietly there. But they were led by the vice chairman of the body of past president, Father Mr. Raf Osayem, who read one of the lessons. Thank you so much. Mr. Deo Ekundayo, when I saw him, I said, wow, this is a wonderful one. Thank you so much for being part of this. Masio Sike Unebu, thank you so much, sir, for staying with us since 1 p.m. and then you kept on praying for us. Thank you, sir. Mr. Lauye Ayola, he said, look, and many people will not know, he donated this choral group to us. He's been saying it in the last 2 years, that look, when next we are going to have the evening of songs, I will bring my choral group from my papa. And these, we call them the God's Own Choir of St. George. And truly, you are God's own. Thank you so much. I can also tell you that apart from Mr. Ayola, we also have Deacon Segun Ajibola online. And we have Dr. Uche Messiah Olowu. That's our Messiah in CIDN. Believe you me, it was during this time we started the evening of songs. So, is he not truly a Messiah? I think he deserves a round of applause. Also, I think we have Dr. Segun Aina in the house, FCIB. Dr. Tech is online, is also online. You can see many of our UK members, they are with us. The United States members, they are with us live and direct online. Thank you very much. I'd like to say thank you to all the office holders. I am a very lucky chief executive. All the office holders are men of God. All the office holders are men of God. The first vice president is a pastor in Redeem. The second vice president is a pastor in his church. The national treasurer, we didn't know until some few weeks ago, when he was to bury his mother, we discovered the pastor in him. I think putting all of them together, you can see why God is residing in CIDN. Let's appreciate it. The governing council members are here. There are so many. I have Mrs. Mercy Ojo. I have Mrs. Yvonne Isiche, who read one of the lessons. I have Mrs. Bakari is there. I want to thank you very much. I have former APWB chairperson, Mrs. S.D. Ige. Thank you very much. And I have the current APWB chairperson. She came in very quietly, Funkela Dimeji. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for making it. Let me also say this, that the Evening of Songs is one program that started when things were almost getting wrong, when you see the whole world. But in the turbulence, in the challenges, this institute, we have cause to say thank you to the Almighty God. So it's a banking industry program, because the banking industry actually must continue to thank the Almighty God. Permit me to also appreciate my kid brother, the very Reverend Lawrence Oyebanjo Awojobi. Behind this rebellious registrar are men of God who pray for him to always make him to realize that God and God alone is the one who is doing it. And of course, around us are beautiful women who serve God. And those women, they are led by the wife of all the presidents of the institute. You can see my president with a pastor, Mrs. Sitting beside him. Pastor, Mrs. Olubemi, thank you so much. I call them Awon Fadura Jagun. Many people may not know, those are the prayer warriors. When their husbands are going to Bauchi in the heat of people running away, and we are ready to face Maiduguri, and we are going to Nekede, the women are there, and the Lord will continue to hold it. Thank you so much to my entire colleagues in the banking industry. I want to say thank you to you. Most importantly, I want to thank the body of bank CEOs that supports this institute very strongly. Thank you so much. My colleagues in the office, I have Alhaji Shonubi. He was the arrowhead of this year's Evening of Songs. Shagun Shonubi, I think you should stand up and take a bow. We went for retreat, and Shagun took up the prayer mantle, and he started praying. I told my people, I said, God is in full control. Thank you so much, Shagun. God bless you. Today, thank you so much. Aki, the chairman of the organizing committee, thank you so much. And Rita and Co, thank you so much. To all other members of the institute, we are transcending the horizon by the grace of God. We shall transcend the horizon, but let's not forget what Daddy told us. We must charge ourselves, and we must also see the vision. When we set that vision, we will definitely achieve it. To everybody, especially once again to this beautiful choral group, we want to say thank you. Thank you, and God bless you. Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year in advance.
My registrar deserves a round of applause. Thank you. Before we take the session out, I would like to announce that there'll be photographs with our Lord Spiritual here present, and the other will be with the office holders, followed by our past president, then followed by other governing council members at the media wall. Now, to give the closing prayer, I would like to call on our first vice president and the person of Dr. Ken Opara, FCIB. Thank you.
Let us pray. Our eternal rock of ages, omnipotent and omniscient God, we remain ever grateful to you. You say you inhabit the praise of your people. And today we have no doubt that your presence has fully felt today. We thank you for the opportunity to express and praise you, because it's only the living that can praise the Lord. We thank you for that privilege. We do not take it for granted. Father, we bless you for all you have done for us as an institute, as a country. Lord, we know that if not your grace, what would have been our faith? But we have the joy that you have kept us the whole of 2021. And we know it's by your special mercy that we are not consumed. As we part this day, we are not parting out of your presence. We ask that your presence shall continually go with us. Amen. You shall usher us into 2022 in a glorious way, that the blessings of 2022 shall be bigger than 2021. At the end of it, we shall have cause to glorify your name. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
So let's take the CIBN anthem and the national anthem. Thank you. national hymn. We will say, we wish you a Merry Christmas, and we'll close.
I wanna reach you.